she above us all, shepherd of us all,
savior of us all, lover of us all.
We are on the Lord's side.
Spirit, O Lord, and make them spiritually sound and fit, O Lord, to run this race to the end in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, as many of us that we hear your word this morning, make every one of us to be a noble doer of your word, and let your name alone be glorified. Thank you, Father. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Brethren, this morning we are looking at a very brief presentation I titled, What Shall We Do? Let's quickly turn our Bible to the book of Acts chapter 2. I read verse 37. It said, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Brethren, this is a vital question every true believers of God should continue to ask themselves. And the word of God is coming to you every day in this ministry. Does it prick your heart? The Bible makes us to understand. The first message after Peter received the power of the Holy Ghost, the first message he preached, he said, the Bible said he pricked their heart, and they begin to ask Peter, what shall we do? Let's read further. This question, or better still, is a phrase for every Christian to consider very well if we must survive in this Christian race that we are running. The Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 2 from verse 32 to 26, I want us to turn our Bible. Let's turn our Bible to Acts chapter 2. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that we'll get a clearer picture of what Peter was making them to understand. Acts chapter 2, I read from verse 32. Acts chapter 2, verse 32. He said, this Jesus has God raised up, whereof we all are witness. 33. Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted, having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, he has shed forth this, which ye now see and hear. 34. For David is not ascended unto the heavens, but he said himself, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit down on my right hand. Verse 35. Until I make the foes the footstool. 36. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God had made that same Jesus, whom you have crucified, both Lord and Christ. In verse 37, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Brethren, what shall you do? As the word of God is coming to you every day, it's a vital question every one of us need to answer us. For us to be able to flee from the condemnation that is coming to the world, from the wrath of God that is coming to this world, what shall we do? The word of God must prick our heart for the renewment of our spiritual consciousness, for the renewment of our heart, for the renewment of our soul, to bring us to that stage of perfection that we may be able to appear before the Lord in happiness, not in disgrace, not in shame. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, the Bible makes us to understand in the book of Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12, it says, for the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and spirit and of the joint and marrow, is a discerner of the thought and the intent of the heart. Brethren, that was the word they heard. When they heard the word of God, the word of God pricked their heart and they asked Peter, what shall we do? Praise Master Jesus Christ. I want you and I to ask ourselves this vital question. Does the word of God still prick me in my heart? until you can answer this question correctly, heaven is far. When the word of God is coming to your heart, do you use it as a mirror to checkmate your life? Do you use it as a mirror to begin to see the dent, to begin to see the loophole, to begin to see the way you are missing it? Do you begin to cross your eye, to begin to dot your eye and cross your T, and begin to know where you are missing it? Then it is a vital question you and I need to answer. The devil we are dealing with is the legal expert. The devil has concluded plans already to devour, to kill. The Bible makes us understand in the book of John, he said, "The thief cometh not to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ said, I have come to give you life." Brethren, if you go to 1 Peter chapter 5, they say, he said, "Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour." Brethren, the only way you can flee from this devourer, the only way you can escape from this accuser, is when the word of God pricks you in your heart. As the word of God is coming every day in this mountain, does it prick you in your heart? In verse 37, I read it again. He said, when they heard these things, he said, he pricked them in their heart and asked Peter, "What shall we do?" Brethren, until the word of God prick you in your heart, you will not restitute. Until the word of God prick you in your heart, you will not repent. Until the word of God prick you in your heart, you will not be reconciled back to God. Until the word of God prick you in your heart, you remain an embodiment of wrath of God. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
The only thing that can deliver you from the claws and wings of the devil is when this question or phrase, "What shall we do?" prick you. When this word or phrase prick you in your heart, then change will come, obedience will come. Then you will not follow after righteousness, you will follow after holiness. Because until, except this word prick you in your heart, you remain what? A food for the devourer. You remain a food for the devil. Until he pricks you in your heart, you will take what we call a dramatic U-turn that will make you to be reconciled back to your Father. Praise Master Jesus Christ. And when the word of God pricked them in their heart, and they asked Peter, "What shall we do?" As the way the word of God is coming to you and I now, Peter said unto them in verse 38, he said, "Repent, be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sin." You can see the result of the word of God. When the word prick it in your heart, you now begin to say, "Oh, I will not lie again. I will not commit fornication again. I will not commit adultery again. I will go for my restitution. I will maintain peace. I will show love. I will keep my heart pure." Until the word of God pricks you in your heart. He said, "Then Peter said unto them, Repent, be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sin, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost." Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In verse 39, he said, "For the promise is unto you and unto your children and to all that are far off." We, Israelite by redemption, children of God, Israelite by redemption. He said, "And for the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord God shall call." In verse 40, And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, "Save yourself from the untold generation." My beloved brethren, the devil, the adversary, is hovering around seeking whom to devour. And the only way you can flee from the devourer, the only way you can flee from the wings and caprices of the devil, is for the word of God to prick you in your heart. When the word of God prick you in your heart, it will corroborate what in the book of Romans chapter 10, if you read from verse 8, the Bible makes us to understand in the book of Romans chapter 10, verse 8, he said, But what said it? The word is near unto thee, evil in the mouth and in the heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Verse 9, that if thou shalt confess with the mouth and the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in the heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be what? Saved. Until the word of God prick you in your heart, you will never be saved. Praise Master Jesus Christ. In verse 10 of Romans chapter 10, he said, "For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness," until the word of God prick you in your heart. In verse 37 that I just read now, he said, "And the word of God pricked them in their heart, and they asked Peter, what shall we do?" What shall we do? Look at verse 10 here. He said, for with the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. Remember what Peter told them. Accept the Lord Jesus Christ. The only way you can accept the Lord Jesus is when the word of God prick you in your heart and make you to fall down and say, Father, I am a sinner. I know without me being accepting you, I was condemned already. Thank you, Jesus, for bringing your word my way. Until the word of God prick you in your heart. For with the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. And with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture said, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. Until the word of God preached you, you will ever be ashamed. You will be ashamed when you appear before his presence, and you remain in shame in hellfire. I pray that will not be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
When the word of God prick you in your heart, restitution will follow. First of all, salvation will follow. Then you become born again. Restitution will follow. You will be redeemed. Love will take over your heart. There will be what we call total surrender. When the word of God prick you in your heart, joy will come. When the word of God prick you in your heart, you will be a new creature. For the word of God says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. When the word of God prick you in your heart, you become a new being. You become a new baby, because the Adamic nature will be gone. You will be reconciled back to your father. You will be like a sheep without shearer. You will be like a sheep without a herdsman. When the word of God prick you in your heart, you will be not able to trace your root, your origin back. You will not begin to reawaken your spiritual consciousness, the reason and your being on this earth. Praise Master Jesus Christ. When the word of God prick you in your heart, you will be purged, you will be purified. He said, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Just like the way they told Peter. Peter, what shall we do? What shall we do for us to be redeemed? What shall we do for us to flee from the wrath that is about to befall this world? Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 18, he said, and all things are of God who had reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and has given to us the ministry of reconciliation. Hallelujah.
Man.
When the word of God prick you in your heart, you will be reconciled back again to the Lord Jesus Christ, the owner of your soul, the innermost being of your being, the reason for your existence. Without him, you are less than nothing. Without him, you can do nothing. Without you, you are like a walking corpse. In other words, without Jesus Christ, you are an embodiment of wrath, according to the book of John chapter 3, verse 36. John chapter 3, verse 36, turn your Bible there. He said, he that believeth on the Son had everlasting life. You have everlasting life. The only thing that can give you everlasting life, when you hear the word of God, he pricks you in your heart. You say, no more malice, no more anger. I will restitute. This man that I'm married to is a second man. I will not marry this man anymore. Until the word of God prick you in your heart. When the word of God prick you in your heart, there will be revival in your life. Praise Master Jesus. Every fantastical behavior will go until the word of God prick you in your heart. The question now is, does the word of God prick you in your heart? You need to answer yourself that question. Brother Peace need to answer himself that vital question. In Psalm 24, verse 14, he said, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him. He showed them his covenant. Until the word of God prick you in your heart, you cannot know the secret of the Lord. He cannot show you his covenant until the word of God prick you in your heart. The Bible makes us to understand in book of Psalm 74, verse 20, he said, having respect unto the covenant, for the darkest place of the earth is full of the habitation of cruelty. The only thing that can redeem you and bring you out from the habitation of the cruelty, for them not to slay you, for them not to devour you, for you not to be a pursuit for them to eat, is for the word of God to prick you in your heart. When the word of God prick you in your heart, every spiritual darkness will be chased out of your life. You will become a new being. You will become a new baby in the Lord. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Until the word of God pricks you in your heart. Look at what Peter makes us understand there. If you read Vita, when the word of God pricks them in the heart, there will be unity in the body of Christ. You will not interpret the Bible to suit your taste. You will not interpret the Bible to make merchandise of your member. You will not interpret the Bible to lead the flocks of God astray. Rather, the fear of God will eclipse your heart. The fear of God will cover you, because the word of God pricks you in your heart. Because the Bible says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The day you begin to fear God, you begin to run away from sin. You begin to run from every appearances of evil. Then it shows that the word of God is pricking you in your heart. David said, because of the word that I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. I ask you again this hour. I ask myself this better question. Does the word of God prick you in your heart? Ask yourself that better question. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
If you read further, in verse 32, because the word of God pricked them in their heart, because they have the fear of God. This was the same Peter that denied Jesus Christ. Right now, he fear God now. He has received the power of the Holy Ghost. He's loaded with the power of the Holy Ghost. The word of God pricked him in their heart, and he was exercising the authority. If you go to verse 12, he said they continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine, fellowship, and in breaking of bread and prayers, because the word of God pricked them in their heart. Is there unity in the body of Christ today? You make merchandise of your member. You lead them astray. You preach them. You teach them what you want, not what God wants them to hear. The wrath of God is waiting for you. You are an embodiment of the wrath of God. Hell is not far from you. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
In verse 33, he said, and fear came upon every soul. Not this scripture very well. He said, and fear came upon every soul. What made fear to come then? Did Jesus Christ appear then to physically? No, because of the power in the world. Because the Bible makes you and I to understand. In the book of Hebrews chapter 4, the Bible makes us to understand that the word of God is quicker, powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword. The only reason your healing will come speedily is when the word of God pricks you in your heart. When you key into it and you begin to confess it, you will not even know when the sickness will go. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
He said, and fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles, because of what? The word of God pricked them in their heart. The word of God was quick and powerful, and the glory of God covered them, because of what? They fear God. When you fear God, it shows that, yes, the word of God pricks you in your heart. Before you take any decision, you always ask a question. Jesus, do you permit what I'm about to do now? Is it in accordance with your will for my life? Because every man, there is a divine will and plan and purpose for every soul on this earth. In verse 45, he said they sold their possession. 44, let's take 44 now. He said, all they that believe we are together and had all things common. Brethren, look at it very well. Because the word of God was prick them in their hearts. They share all things in common. There was unity. There was love. They bear one another's body. Why? Because the word of God was in their heart. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Verse 45. And they sold their possession and goods and parted them to all men as every man had needs. 46. And they continued daily with one accord in the temple, breaking bread from house to house, and did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of the heart. When the word of God pricks you in your heart, there will be a total reformation in your life, in your spiritual life. That Adamic nature will die totally. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
In verse 47, he said, praising God, having favor with all people, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. Brethren, am I not being a stumbling block to the Lord? Ask yourself, are you not being a stumbling block to the Lord? Because the word of God does not prick in your heart. People still see you the way you are, as a troublemaker, as a noisemaker. People still know you, that you sow the seed of discord in the heart of people. You cause confusion. Anywhere you go, you are known for confusion, because the word of God does not prick in your heart, because you don't have the fear of God. Consider the scripture. He said, praising God and having favor with all people, and the Lord added to the church. He added to the church because what? They have the fear of God. They see the light of God. And people said, I want to know the God that you serve. With somebody in your house, will your neighbor tell you, I want to know the God that you serve? When you know that you are a troublemaker, you wake up in the night, you shout, you disturb, you scream everybody down, but there is no love in you, there is no outcome of Christianity in you. Ask yourself this vital question. I need to ask myself this question. We all need to go back again to our spiritual drawing board and begin to dot our I and begin to cross our T. brethren, at this junction, I want every one of us to go on our knee and talk to the Lord. Say, Father, in any way, I have defied your word. In any way, I have compromised. In any way, I have done things that is contrary against your divine plan and purpose. Father, have mercy upon me. In any way, I have matched your word instead of allowing your word to purify, to sanctify me. Talk to the Lord to have mercy in this hour. That henceforth, as the word of God will be coming, let it begin to sanctify me. Let it begin to touch me. Let it begin to purify me. Almighty and most everlasting Father, I thank you. I bless you. I magnify your name. King of kings, you have spoken to us again, crystal clear unto us. Father, I pray as many of us that have heard your word this hour, every one of us will take action and walk according to your word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, your word, O Lord, says that the parable of the sower was not with the problem with the parable of the sower was not with the seed, neither it was with the sower. It was with the environment that the seed fall upon. Father, I pray that our dirty heart will not choke your word. Our dirty heart will not dilute your word. Rather, as your word is coming, the light that goes with it, the power that goes with it, will pierce into our heart, will prick our heart and transform us to become a new creature unto you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Father, I pray that this word will not be used against me. It will not be used against the hearer, your children. Rather, this word shall make every one of us rapture ready, purified, sanctified in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, have I spoken out of context? Have I said what I ought not to have said? I ask for your mercy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed with thanksgiving.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bless you, Kuoka. May love strengthen you and follow you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible told us in the book of Genesis, chapter 8, verse 5, and the water decreased continually until the 10th month. In the 10th month, on the first day of the month, where the top of the mountain thing. I come again. And the water decreased continuously. I'm talking about after God used water to destroy the earth. And the water decreased continuously until the 10th month. In the 10th month, on the first day of the month, at the top of the mountain saying, I want to pray. I say, Father, from today henceforth, let your glory be seen upon my life as your word come upon this mountain day and night. Let your glory be seen, be repeated upon my life. This month, this 10th month, let your word prick my heart so that the people will know that I am truly a child of God. In Jesus' name, open your mouth and pray.
Father,
in the name of Jesus, Father, I will no longer waste your word again. Father, from January to now, I have been wasting your word, but from today, I will no longer be a waster of your word. Every single word that comes to me again from this in this mountain, I shall make do of it judiciously, gloriously, in the name of Jesus Christ. Okay, Mother, pray.
Amen.
The Bible says, "Are they continual daily in the apostles' doctrine, breaking of bread and in prayer?" I want to pray, say, Father, from now on, I will continue in your word. I will no longer leave your word again. I will no longer defy myself again. I will continue in holiness, in righteousness, till you come and pick me home. In the name of Jesus Christ, okay, Mother, pray.
Father, I cry before you. I will continue, Lord. Holiness and righteousness. I will never defy my body. I will never defy my life. God, help me,
In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you.
In the name of Jesus, I receive the grace I die.
In Jesus Christ, let me free. Last day, the Bible says, the first shall be the last, and the last shall be the first. God wants to specify whatever that will mean to be the first that later be the last. They will be looking for me in heaven, they will not see me because of little mistake, because of offense. Father, I come against you, Lord. Help me to stand strong, to stand firm, even to the end of time. In Jesus' name, open my prayer.
Father, help me, Lord, for me not to be the last, Lord. I call upon your name, help us, Lord, for us not to be the last, Lord. Mighty, call upon your name.
Jesus Christ, mighty name, pray.
Amen.
This was the word for this morning. The Lord knows what he's doing. And I pray every one of us, this word will prick our hearts whatever restitution we need to do, we're going to do them. Anyway, we have been offending God. Lord, help us to overcome. The grace will go back home and ask the Holy Spirit, what do I do? That spirit of what do I do will be released upon us today in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Yeah, you're not born again. Ask yourself, ask the Holy Spirit now, what do you do? And what you should do is receive Christ now, or else it might be too late for you tomorrow. Say after me, if you want to do so, you have asked the question, what do I do? This is what you should do now. Say after me, say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I realize I'm dirty, living in iniquity. But this hour, your word is purging me. Your word is purifying me. I've decided to believe that you are the Son of God. You came to die for my sin. You resurrected for my justification. Satan, you have tricked me for so long. I've dwelt with you in darkness for too long. But today, my eyes is open. The 10th month, the 12th month I've been seen. Today, I've seen the light. Satan, leave me alone. Lord Jesus, I accept today as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life, come and dwell in me. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I go now to sin no more. Father, on that day, I will be part of you in heaven. So help me God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I pray with you wherever you are over the world. You have accepted this. You have confessed this confession. It's the 10th month, and the Lord is making your life clearer and clearer from today henceforth. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The grace will stand strong, to stand firm to the end of time. This evening, now you have just enrolled into the race to eternity in heaven. The Lord will strengthen you, will empower you, nothing will offend you. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.